Have you ever seen a large machine that continuously moves up and down at an oil drilling site? This machine is known as a pumping unit. Its constant up and down motion makes it resemble a person nodding repeatedly, which is why people often refer to it as a nodding donkey or pump jack. Behind its simple movement, this machine plays a crucial role in the petroleum industry, pumping oil from deep underground to the surface. In this video, we will discuss in detail how this pump jack works, starting from its power source, its movement mechanism, to the separation process of the extracted oil. At first glance, the pump jack seems like a simple device. It only moves slowly up and down, as if nothing special is happening. However, it is this very movement that makes it possible for underground crude oil to be lifted continuously to the surface. This machine is generally used on oil wells where the reservoir pressure is no longer strong enough to push the oil out naturally. Therefore, an auxiliary device such as a pump jack is needed to maintain oil production from these wells. The pump jack is powered by an electric motor, which serves as its main power source. This motor is connected to a gearbox, which functions to adjust the motor's rotational speed, slowing it down to suit the system's needs. From the gearbox, the power is transmitted to the main part of the machine, which is the walking beam and pitman arm assembly. This mechanism converts rotational motion into an up and down reciprocating motion. At the end of the walking beam is a component shaped like a head that moves up and down regularly. This component pulls and pushes a long rod called the sucker rod, which extends deep into the oil well all the way to the subsurface pump. Inside the well, there is a pump that operates on a principle similar to a manual water pump you may have seen in rural areas. This pump is equipped with two valves, a suction valve at the bottom and a discharge valve at the top. When the sucker rod is pulled upward by the pump jack on the surface, the suction valve at the bottom opens, allowing fluid from the well, consisting of a mixture of oil, water, and gas, to enter the pump barrel. At the same time, the discharge valve at the top remains closed to prevent the fluid from flowing back down. Conversely, when the sucker rod is pushed downward, the suction valve closes while the discharge valve opens. The pressure created by this movement forces the fluid inside the pump barrel upward through the production tubing that connects directly to the surface. This process happens continuously, creating a steady flow of oil. The working principle is very similar to a manual water pump. However, in the case of the pump jack, the entire process is powered by electricity and is used to pump fluids from much greater depths. The fluid pumped from underground by the pump jack is not just crude oil alone. Usually, it is a mixture of crude oil, water, and gas. Therefore, once this fluid reaches the surface, the next step is to separate these components so that each can be processed further according to its purpose. The produced fluid from the well is directed to a device called a separator or separation tank. Inside this tank, the gas, oil, and water components naturally separate based on their differences in specific gravity. Gas, being the lightest component, rises to the top of the tank. Typically, this gas is immediately flared off through a flare stack if there are no special facilities to process it further. Crude oil, which is lighter than water but heavier than gas, stays in the middle. It is then channeled into an oil storage tank to be sent to a refinery for processing. Water, being the heaviest component, settles at the bottom of the tank and is discharged to a holding pond, or treated further in accordance with environmental regulations and operational needs.